A dollar today is worth more than a dollar tomorrow. I'm sure you heard that one before. This is true for any business, but also for your own personal finance. It's a simple principle that has a fancy name, the time value of money. For example, you're selling a product for, let's say $10,000. One day a customer asks you if instead of paying the $10,000 in cash right now, that he can pay $10,800 in equal payments over 4 years. What would you say? What's better for you? Let's find out. Before we get started, a brief thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. Skillshare is a learning platform with lots of great courses, but I'm going to chat more about them towards the end. You're going to find a link as well in the description of the video. So intuitively, you'll know that if someone promised you $1,000 now, it's a better deal than, let's say, getting the $1,000 in 10 years, right? But why is that? Well, for one, money has an earning capacity. So you could take the $1,000 and you could invest it and hopefully make more out of it. So there may be some lost opportunity to make an additional income. Also, money loses value because prices are increasing over time. That's called inflation. And finally, there is a risk factor. Who knows what's going to happen in like 10 years? Will you really get the money then? There's also that uncertainty factor involved. The combination of the factors defines the time value of money and is usually expressed as a percentage, a discount rate. This discount rate is always specific to your specific situation. So my discount rate may be higher or lower than yours, depending on how we think these three factors are going to impact us in the coming years. One is, are your opportunity costs high because you know of this other great investment that you could do instead? Do you think inflation will be 2%, 5%, or even higher? And third is, do you think the risk of not getting paid is high or low? Also, the further in the future the payments are, the more opportunity cost, inflation, and risk you're going to have. That takes away from the value. So when you're comparing alternatives, always consider the timing of when the payments are going to happen. So let's come back to my initial question. Is it better to get the $10,000 today or get $10,800 over 4 years? So in order to answer that, we need to compare the value of both options at the same point in time, meaning today. In other words, we need to calculate today's or the present value of the future payments of the $10,800. So let's switch to Excel and check it out. So here are our two options. Year zero represents today, one means 1 year from now, and so on. The undiscounted total of $10,800 is obviously higher than the alternative $10,000 now. By undiscounted, I mean that the time value of money isn't considered here. It's just adding up the payments that we're going to be receiving in the future. Because payments in the future have less value than an equal payment today, we need to discount them. Basically, we need to reduce them to get the present value for these payments. What is $2,700 worth to us right now? Let's assume our discount rate is 5%. This essentially means that in each successive year, the same amount of money is going to be worth 5% less than in the previous year. It's like the opposite of earning interest on a deposit. Instead of increasing the value, it's decreasing the value, it's worth less. Let's calculate for year one first, what $2,700 is worth to us right now. Basically, what is its present value? First, I'm going to do this manually using a simple formula, and then we're actually going to use an Excel function to do this whole calculation for us. The manual approach helps us understand the underlying engine behind this formula, behind the calculation. To calculate what this amount is worth to us now, we're going to take this number, the 2,700, and we're going to divide it by 1 plus the discount rate. Close bracket, press enter. Now, you might be wondering, why are we dividing this? That's because we're moving backwards. We're going from the future down to the present. If we were going forward, so let's assume this is our starting money. I'm going to put this money in the bank. The bank is going to give me 5% interest on this. How much is this money in 1 year? The answer should be this, right? So let's do the calculation. It's going to be this number. Instead of dividing, I need to multiply because I'm going into the future. So I'm going to multiply this with 1 plus the, this time it's the interest rate here, close bracket, press enter, and I get my value. One thing you need to remember, if you're going backwards from the future to the present, you need to divide. You're going into the future, you need to multiply. Now, if we use the same concept and calculate the amount for the second year, we have to change our basis because our basis is now this. So we're going to take this, divide it by 1 plus the discount rate, and I'm going to fix it because I want to pull this across here. You can see that as the years go by, our $2,700 is worth a lot less. The amount keeps decreasing. Now, another way of writing this, or a simpler way of writing this, is to use the present value formula right here. PV stands for present value. CF is the payment in the future, it's our cash flow. In the denominator, we have the discount rate. That's the R, so that's our rate right here. And N stands for the number of years from now, which we're going to receive the payment. So it's just another way of writing the formula that we just wrote. It's pretty much the same, so it's going to take this value, divide it by 1 plus our discount rate, and I'm going to fix this. But just so that we don't have to reference back to the previous year, we can take this to the power of the period right here. So you need to find this operator. And if you can't find it, you can also use the power function in Excel. So with that, I'm going to press enter and drag this across, and we get the same numbers like we did before. Okay, so this is just two different ways of doing this manual calculation. Okay, I'm just going to remove this one. Let's just sum these up to see what we get. 9,574. Getting 2,700 for 4 years is actually worth right now $9,574, which is less than our option one. This means option two is not a good opportunity. Now, the good news is if you're using Excel, we have a great function called the NPV. It's the net present value. And we can use that to quickly calculate if an opportunity makes sense or not. The first argument here is the rate, which is this one. And then we just need to give it our value. So this is the cash flow returns that we're going to get, which is this range right here. If I press enter, we get the same number that we got here. We just got it in one step. And to see if this opportunity makes sense or not, I can deduct it from my original option, and I end up with minus 426, which means it's not a good opportunity. It's better for me to get 10,000 right now instead of getting 10,800 over 4 years. But all of this was based on the assumption that the discount rate is 5%. What if the discount rate was something else? So what if it was 2%? Then things start to change. My net present value here is positive. I end up getting more money with the discounted version of option two than option one. So if the discount rate was going to be that low and I could rely on this assumption, I could say yes, 10,800 over 4 years is actually a better deal for me. Now you might be wondering, what's the correct discount rate to use? Well, that depends on how you assess the three factors impacting the time value of money: opportunity cost, inflation, and risk for your particular situation. So for companies, it's related to how they get their funds. They use a discount rate that's usually an average of rate of return that their investors expect and the cost of borrowing money. That's called their WACC, for weighted average cost of capital. By applying this as the discount rate, any project that delivers a positive NPV is worth doing. So here's an example. You want to buy a new machinery that costs $50,000. You calculated that it would bring productivity savings of $15,000 for the next 4 years. Afterwards, the machine is going to have to be replaced. So if we don't consider the return percentage right now, and we just take a look at the cash flow, we're going to have in year one, the $15,000. So let's just fix this with F4. And the same amount until end of year four. In year zero, our cash flow is negative because we just spent $50,000 on this. Now, if I just calculate the sum of this on the side, we're going to end up with a profit of $10,000. With this, we might think, oh, that's actually not a bad investment. And you go to your boss and you present this business case to them. Your boss takes a look at this and says, okay, that's great, but the shareholders expect at least 8% return on their money. So he only wants to invest in projects that will give him at least this kind of return. Is the project worth doing now or not? So let's see. So let's put 8% right here. And this time, let's immediately take advantage of Excel's NPV function. Our rate is this one. The values here are right here. If I close bracket and I press enter, this is the present value of my future cash flows. Now let's deduct the original amount that I invested. And since it's a minus here, I'm just gonna add this to the NPV function and my net present value ends up being negative. This means that the project is not gonna deliver the minimum return the shareholders are requesting. But what if the minimum return was a little less? What if it was 6%? Then everything starts to look different. The net present value becomes positive. So that's how the time value of money is applied in a simple business case. I want you to take away two key things. Always consider the timing of when payments are done. The further in the future the payments are, the lower their present value will be. Think of the discount rate as like a hurdle. The higher the hurdle, the more difficult it's going to be to get a high present value. If you're looking for a good resource on personal finance or managing your money habits, I can recommend Justin Bridges' course. It's called Modern Money Habits, 5 Steps to Build the Life You Want. It's about taking charge of your personal finances. Now, what I especially liked about it is how he records everything in a spreadsheet so you have a clear overview of your finances. Taking classes on Skillshare is really affordable too. An annual subscription is less than $10 a month, and premium membership gives you unlimited access so you can join any class on any topic that interests you right now, whether that's freelancing, technical skills like office skills, or any topic you'd like to explore more of. Because Skillshare is sponsoring this video, I have a special link for you in the description of the video that is going to give you 2 months free trial. So make sure you check it out. I hope this video was helpful for you to get familiar with the concept of the time value of money. And I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't done so already.